I just finished reading 158 pages of Formula One 2022 technical regulations by FIA to make this video.
Well, I would read it for pleasure too. Does that make sense?
Today we're going to talk about FIA's 2022 regulations for Formula One cars. 2022 regulations designed to enable closer racing throughout the field with a more balanced competition on track and on R&D. Remember the amazing defense Alonso put with Lewis Hamilton in Hungarian Grand Prix? With these regulations, we will actually get to see more of these exciting battles. To facilitate closer racing and give the following cars a chance to catch and overtake, FIA took measurements to reduce downforce. The cars of 2022 were born precisely with the aim of drastically reducing aerodynamic sensitivity with a more simplified shape over the entire car. With current designs, the dirty air coming from the car on the front is making the car unstable to drive. To reduce downforce, a new aero package, including underfloor, front wing, rear wing and floor structure is introduced while the side skirt is eliminated. Current cars lose 35% downforce around 20 meter distance and 46% at 10 meter distance. In 2022, however, cars lose 4% downforce around 20 meters, 18% around 10 meters. So chasing cars can stay closer for longer and can overtake easier. Front wings are being redefined. Unlike this season, front wings will only have four components. This redesigned front wing is simpler than before and has wing flaps that now stretch all the way to the nose, and they're no longer adjustable. This eliminates the inner wingtips found on the current cars, which created a vortex that pronounced much of the dirty aerodynamic wake. Nose is now attached directly to the wing. It will no longer be raised with respect to the front wing, but will form a single integral element. So the front section of the frame will also be lower than it is now, resulting in the repositioning of all front suspension mounts. Talking about suspensions, they also are going through some changes. No more torsion bars will be allowed. Heave springs will also be banned. Only springs and dampers will be allowed. If you want to learn what these are, wait for my next video about suspension systems. If you see a link here right now, the video is probably already uploaded. Suspension uprights will solidly be included in the wheel assembly. Let's loop back to aero package. Rear wing is curved upwards to push the air up, allowing cars that are behind to chase closer. Instead of wings and end plates, it's now a beam wing loop mounted to the rear end of the car, again, to reduce turbulent air for the following car. The wing will be supported not only by the vertical pylons, but there will be the return of the beam wing. That is the horizontal wing above the diffuser. Another aero update is that, unlike 2021, rather than relying on the front wing to generate downforce, in 2022, a 3D-shaped floor will generate more underfloor downforce without disrupting the airflow. This is to compensate for the lost downforce effect with simpler wings. Deep underfloor tunnels will produce downforce through a ground effect. So there will be less turbulent air for the following car again. And you guessed it right, it will allow the racers to follow each other closer. As you can see on this CFD analysis, air pattern is so much more different with the new car design. The following car is dealing with much more clean air. DRS systems remains for now, but it may not if these new alterations are enough. With new season, ground effect cars are making a return for the first time since 1982 in an effort to get rid of the dirty air. Are you asking how will they create the ground effect? Cars won't have sliding skirts. Say goodbye to slots, vortex generators and so on. Instead, they will have a range of fins. air will enter through a very pronounced entry through the venturi tunnels. As air moves towards under the car, it will be squeezed through the lowest point closest to the ground, developing extremely lower pressure area. Low pressure area will generate large amount of suction underneath this side of curvature, generating downforce. There are no more confusing barge boards to reduce wake force, though I genuinely enjoyed the result of such an amazing end product of topology optimization. Lack of barge boards will reduce the wake. Wheel covers are returning with a deflector on top. Wheel rim covers are also making a return, which will control the wake created by the front tire while encapsulating the heat generated by the brakes. If you want to know more about the importance of temperature on brake systems, check out my F1 brakes video. Sizes in wheel rims changed from 13 to 18 inches, consequently tire profile is reduced significantly, meaning tire will deform less. So there will be less turbulent air due to squished tires. Check out this video if you want to see how aerodynamics in an F1 car works. I'm not a big fan of larger tire rims. Fia says this is to improve performance, but I disagree. Bigger wheels simply will increase the weight of the car. You want lighter cars for a better performance! Normally in commercial vehicles, as horsepower increases, so does the size of the wheels. But for NASCAR, IndyCar and Formula 1 cars, the case is the opposite. Although these cars have high horsepower, they are paired with smaller, therefore lighter wheels to get that higher horsepower to weight ratio, which will lead to faster cars. James Allison, the technical director of Mercedes, also agrees that these tires aren't the most performance-enhancing novelty. He says that these wheels slow the cars down by 2 seconds per lap, equivalent of losing 125 horsepower. According to him, if you like those bigger wheels, it's because you're either a 13-year-old boy or a fan of Fast and Furious films. In a car, adding linear mass is equivalent to reducing horsepower because it increases mass to power ratio. And the weight these wheels add isn't only linear mass, but also a rotational mass. Rotational mass is how difficult it is to turn an object. Though I don't know the exact material properties of wheel compound, if we guesstimate, a 17-inch wheel weighs 9.4 kilos, 20.7 pounds, an 18-inch wheel weighs about 10.7 kilos, 23.5 pounds. 1 inch adds 1.3 kilos per wheel. 1 inch increase in 4 wheels will add around 5.2 kilograms, which is the weight of a gray fox. That would actually be an interesting race, right? Put a gray fox on racer's lap. Fun fact, Sebastian Vettel used to kart with his teddy bear. Anyways, I'm digressing. That extra 5.2 kilograms is equivalent of losing 5.7 horsepower. Now imagine multiplying that by 5. Where is the rest of that lost 125 horsepower Allison was talking about is coming from? Well, it's caused by the rotational mass that we were talking about. To sum up, FIA is actually slowing the cars down by making the wheels larger. Yeah! With larger wheels, brake discs and pads are also enlarged to match them. Tire blankets will eventually be phased out in 2023, but for now they're staying. Wheel covers and wake control devices will also control the airflow. By regulations, minimum car weight is increased by 5% due to enlarged wheels. Let's talk about money. FIA is bringing an upper budget limit of $175 million to allow low segment teams a fair chance to compete with the teams that had more funds in the past. Marketing and driver salaries are excluded from this cost cap. The 1.6-liter V6 turbo engine rules remain largely the same, but the design of the power units will be homologated at the start of the season and be frozen up till the end of at least 2025. Turbo hybrid power units will have more sensors to allow FIA to monitor the power unit better. Engines will have high RPM. maximum rev unit is raised up to 3000 RPM. And this season, power units are allowed to be a little heavier to reduce the cost. Fuel pumps are standardized, so fuel treasury can be monitored more easily. F1 is committed to go green. So this season, fuel must include 20% biofuels with near zero carbon footprint. New fuel is called E10, which is 10% ethanol and biodegradable made for sustainability. Motor generation heat unit is removed to simplify engine unit. Gearbox development is frozen till 2025. And in 2022, gearbox and clutch mechanisms can be bought from other teams like Haas does. But prescribed parts needs to be designed by teams like wheel hubs and floor T-train. Open source parts can be designed by teams collectively, and these are the DRS mechanisms, brakes, and steering wheels. Let's talk about safety. FIA is always looking to make the sport safer for the drivers. So it's no surprise, new safety features are introduced. Shattered parts and debris during the racing risks everyone's safety. Some parts will be covered with rubber membrane to ensure they don't shatter easily. This will also stop front wings detaching from cars. Side impact structures will be strengthened. Crash structure in the front end will have to withstand 15% more energy in front and rear impact tests. There's another safety measurement brought especially after Romain Grosjean incident. Engines must separate from chassis in a safe manner without exposing the fuel tanks. Every chassis on the grid needs to go through a static squeeze test to prove their strength tests, and the approved magnitude of these tests are increased to ensure a safer racing experience for the drivers. CFD analysis will be more regulated, and there will be wind tunnel runtime and aero testing restrictions to allow each team to have equal opportunities. Each team will have to submit their CAD designs, and 3D scanned cars will be scrutinized to make sure no one is stealing designs from each other. There is a broad overview of the rule set and plenty of room to interpret. The cars teams will come up with will probably look different compared to these models. When these rules were first published, F1 actually mocked up different variants to demonstrate the new regulations aren't too descriptive, and there is some freedom for teams to come up with their own designs. According to Adrian Newey, F1 2022 rule changes are the biggest in 4 decades. It really is an enormous change in every sense of the word. The only thing that really stays the same is the power unit. Everything else is different. Thank you for watching. This was such a pleasure. If you like my content, please subscribe and like this video.